the government to regulate the railroads has been established in both state and federal courts. The railroad is a quasi-public corporation. As such, it exercises the sovereign right of eminent domain, and it cannot escape from this public character. What we need is first to ascertain the value of the railroads, measured by the cost of reproduction, and second, to prevent for the future issues of fictitious capital and whether it stops. When we have put railroad business upon an honest basis, we can proceed with rate reduction without, however, preventing a fair and just return upon the capital invested. Just now, there is considerable discussion as to the relative sphere of the nation and the state, and some have taken the position that railroads should be given national incorporation. The Democratic position, however, is that national remedies should be added to state remedies and not substituted for them. The states should not be deprived of the power which they now have to protect their people against railroad abuses. Congress does not need any additional power. It has more power now than it has exercised, and is by the Constitution given full control over interstate commerce. It is not necessary that Congress shall control commerce within a state in order to effectively regulate interstate commerce. The present demand for national cooperation is not in the interest of the public, but in the interest of the railroads. But the people, Republicans and Democrats, will refuse to surrender any of the power now lodged in the states. This is not an avowal of the Doctrine of Secession, as some of the railroad magnates have tried to make it appear. The question is not whether a state has the right to secede, but whether a state